Lies, I'm sure.
Why did Mistletoe break the spell?
Vanir magic is powerful, but its rules are slippery and elusive. I'm sure it makes sense if you're a witch. Oh, but it's bloody tragic. Baldur was the greatest gift Odin granted Freya, the one thing she treasured from their marriage. I only hope to spare him pain and spare herself loss. But such impulses can lead good parents to make terribly stupid decisions.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half-god and half-giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted in his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I can scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. He won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
You want a beach here?
Bones pulse with magic.
It must be Golvi. Could we just hold on to it? Maybe we'll find the rest of them.
This spirit lies to you, boy.
How would you know?
I have known many spirits. They are all liars.
This one is different. I know it.
You know very little.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
Very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. Now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Become a dragon, Mimir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
answer the boy's question, Head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
Well, I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen it from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Boy.
Hold on. Let me read this.
Since we last crossed paths, I had legs. Go, you wee little bugger. Well, I think Dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Trusting a spirit to keep its word is foolish, boy.
But if there's even a chance, don't you want to see Mom again?
Of course I... She is gone, Atreus. You must accept this.
I do, but to see her again. Just one more time.
Why do you believe him? You do not know him or who he was. All of this is sinister.
He wants to see someone he loved again. I understand how that feels. I don't think there's anything sinister about it.
Don't be blind to your instincts, boy.
More of those. Good. Ah, I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up.
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe, a whetstone?
What is this place?
Ah, could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
Ah, Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
I wanted to fly again.
Yes, that's a terrible pity.
Okay, tell me again how Odin knew we were going to Jotunheim before we did.
Odin is extremely clever, you see. Nearly as clever as he thinks he is. And he's a collector of prophecies. If it's about the future, he adds it to his collection. Helps him style himself as all-seeing and all-knowing. But of course, the idea is control. Control of the future, control of his fate. He'd control every realm of every land in every world if he could. Every potential pocket of resistance, he seeks to eliminate. Even if you've never posed a threat before, he may think one day you might. So you see, it's not important how he knew before you did. It's important that he was right.
Dead alchemist for something I'm stewing.
Here we go! I can't believe we're gonna see the giants!
Well, if things work according to plan... Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way. Probably.
Ready.
Oh, right. Got it. Let's hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure you'll be fine. Ready.
Oh, that's unpleasant!
Now, boy!
Well, what are we waiting for? Think it's far?
We will see.
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.